Anytime you throw your weight behind a political party that controls two-thirds of the government, and that party can't keep the promise that it made to you during election time, and you are dumb enough to walk around continuing to identify yourself with that party, you're not only a chump, but you're a traitor to your race.
Man, he wants you to remain a boy. He wants you to remain a lackey. He wants you to remain dependent on him. He wants you to come looking to him for some kind of advice, for some kind of teacher. No, you teach yourself and stand up for yourself and respect yourself and know yourself and defend yourself and be yourself, and you'll be recognized as an intelligent person.
Whites can help us, but they can't join us. There can be no black-white unity until there is first some black unity. We cannot think of being acceptable to others until we have first proven acceptable to ourselves. Concerning nonviolence, it is criminal to teach a man not to defend himself when he is the constant victim of brutal attacks. There are problems in the community. Some of those examples of those problems are the vices that destroy the moral fiber in our community. Drunkenness, drug addiction, prostitution, organized crime that robs the Negro community of probably 90% of its economic potential and moral potential.
Once you change your philosophy, you change your thought pattern. Once you change your thought pattern, you change your attitude. Once you change your attitude, it changes your behavior pattern. And then you go on into some action. As long as you got a sit-down philosophy, you'll have a sit-down thought pattern. And as long as you think that old sit-down thought, you'll be in some kind of sit-down action. They'll have you sitting in everywhere. It's not so good to refer to what you're going to do as a sit-in. Then right there, castrates you. Right there, it brings you down. What goes with it? What, think of the image of someone sitting. An old woman can sit. An old man can sit. A chump can sit. A coward can sit. Anything can sit. Well, you and I have been sitting long enough, and it's time today for us to start doing some standing and some fighting to back that up. I'm no politician. I'm not even a student of politics. I'm not a Republican, nor a Democrat, nor an American, and got sense enough to know. I'm one of the 22 million black victims of the Democrats. One of the 22 million black victims of the Republicans, and one of the 22 million black victims of Americanism. And when I speak, I don't speak as a Democrat or a Republican, nor an American. I speak as a victim of America's so-called democracy. You and I have never seen democracy. All we've seen is hypocrisy. When we open our eyes today and look around America, we see America not through the eyes of someone who has enjoyed the fruits of Americanism. We see America through the eyes of someone who has been the victim of Americanism. We don't see any American dream. We've experienced only the American nightmare. We haven't benefited from America's democracy. We've only suffered from America's hypocrisy. And the generation that's coming up now can see it and are not afraid to say it. If you go to jail, so what? If you're black, you were born in jail. If you're black, you were born in jail.
Because I think you believe in the God who created the universe, and that's the one we believe in, the one who created the universe. The only difference being, you call him God, and we call him Allah. Jews call him Jehovah. If you could understand Hebrew, you'd probably call him Jehovah too. If you can understand Arabic, you'd probably call him Allah. But since the white man, your friend, took your language away from you during slavery, the only language you know is his language, you know, your friend's language. So you call him, you call for the same God he calls for. When he's putting a rope around your neck, you call for God, he calls for God. And you wonder why the one you call on never answers you.
The slave master took Tom and dressed him well and fed him well and even gave him a little education, a little education. Gave him a long coat and a top hat and made all the other slaves look up to him. Then he used Tom to control them. The same strategy that was used in those days is used today by the same white man. He take a Negro, so-called Negro, and make him prominent. Build him up, publicize him, make him a celebrity. And then he becomes a spokesman for Negroes and a Negro leader.